first touch, but he recovers very quickly. Ali to Mba to Gambo Mohamed out here. A pitch of a goal. So beautifully dispatched. The man with the massive experience here. That's massive. Hele Isaac. Good leap. Rabiu Ali. Deft touches. Omar Zango. Ezekiel Mba. Oh, great touch. And a shot there. Splash! What a goal that was. Well, well, well. Gambo Mohamed. You cannot put him on a leash. He is unplayable. Chinedu Kawawa is aghast. But I don't think that anybody can blame him for that. That shot in itself was absolutely a sizzler. Gambo Mohamed, what a goal.
What a goal indeed. And you can see what it means to the fans. Sighs of relief all around the Carnival Pillar Stadium. This was just absolutely wonderful to see. Four passes into the path of Gambo Mohamed. Boom. Ezekiel Mba started it. Just a couple of touches. And Gambo Mohamed smacked that one into the net. 2-0.
The last pass, of course, coming from Rabiu Ali. Who else? Because that's a deadly combination if there's any in this our game today. But
Ali that time hacked down, came from Kwara United,
and the side netting, you would think it was in the net, but that was Gambo Ibrahim, Gambo Mohamed rather, vintage Gambo Mohamed. He just pulled the trigger when he thought he was in a good enough position to try something.
It was just so unfortunate, that shot just found the side of the net instead of the inside of the net. Gambo Mohamed, 15 goals, Mohamed, 15 goals for Carnival Pillars in 27 appearances. And obviously the highest goal scorer for the side. There are rumors linking him with transfer to a club in Europe.
Every blade of grass on this pitch is here for quite a long time. And he has so much respect. I wonder how he'll cope with this new coach. Remember, he used to be very close to former coach Baba Gennaro. Well, new coaches, new techniques. Let's see how he'll cope.
Very exciting. A shot there from Mohamed, Gambo Mohamed. And I tell you, that is one of his strengths, shooting from afar, from range.
Well, set play there. The ball was left for him, and Gambo hit that house with his left foot. He scraped through the bar just by inches. Gambo is famed for that. But the injuries have sort of stalled Gambo's growth in the game.
And lots of injury problems last season. And can he call in a chance for a cross? He does get a cross. His shot comes in, but very poor. And about just inches away from Gambo Mohamed. Goalkeeper drive the right way, but he couldn't get his hand onto the ball. His shot just went some meters away from the post.
Well, what a beauty shows a lot of understanding. Gambo went there, won the header for Biloko for the matter. For the matter went out wide and brought the ball. These are set pieces. These are mostly what's been done in training. And it shows how deadly Carnival Pillars can be. This is all the team needs to be that deadly. Unfortunately, he didn't well place his boot. Some, errors about technique there, but it's encouraging on the part of Kanu Pillars.
Final, and of course we taught some lessons by TP Mazembe, who won the trophy. A chance for Pillars, the header comes over the bar. Rabioli with that fantastic header. It was Rabioli that assisted that. The header finally came from a big man, Gambo Mohammed.
Well, this shows understanding. A beautiful pull out there. Gambo was well positioned. He kind of flicked the ball. And had that gone on direction, Gokibayezinwaikechukwu wouldn't have any answer. It shows Gambo's experience and Gambo's ability. Unfortunately, on this occasion, he didn't just quite connect.
But that's because the Gambo Mohammed, and a nice understanding. And Gambo Mohammed comes with that. There cross the chance for Kanu Pillars. It's goal number one for Pillars. Was just talking about the Ezekiel in the team, and one of the Ezekiel Mba, is the one that was at the end of that cross from Gambo Mohammed. Ezekiel Mba put in Kanu Pillars, 1-0 up, and a very hot afternoon in Kanu.
Well, perhaps I spoke too soon when I said goalkeeper Ezinwaikechukwu was yet to concede a goal this season. No sooner had I said that Ezekiel Mba buried that ball up a beautiful pull-out. Now I like this understanding. It was Gambo who dropped the ball for Obermata. Obermata returned, and Gambo's pull-out was ably met by a howitzer of a left-foot shot there by Ezekiel Mba, making it one goal for Kanu Pillars and none for Sunshine Wheat, as they were beaten for the first time this season.
Poor communication and it soon shines a defense, but then he must give it to Gambo Mohammed. What a turn and what a cross from him. The throw-in that has quickly been taken. And almost a goal, but Ezenwa! What a goalkeeper! Fantastic goalkeeping from Ikechukwu Ezenwa, former junior international, stopping Kanu Pillars from going into the lead here again.
Fantastic understanding there by the attackers of Kanu Pillars. It was a one-on-one. Gambo gave the ball and it was returned. He then took,
according to their plan, Kanu Pillars, they need to send the ball into the box. And this must be the last ditch attack in football for Kanu Pillars, and it goes. Can he hit it to the net? It is equalizer. Gambo Mohammed has equalized for Kanu Pillars. 96 minutes, the last minute of additional time, and Kanu Pillars has equalized. Gambo Mohammed is it.
Well, Gambo showed so much experience there. He wasn't in a hurry to hit this ball. When he had an opportunity, he used the right leg to cushion the ball, and when the ball was down for him, he then felt he cleverly brought his defender away, chose his spot, and buried it cleverly low under Ikechukwu's despairing dive. Considering how bright Ikechukwu Ezenwa has been, he just had no answer to this shot by Gambo Mohammed.
And Kanu Pillars, Gambo Mohammed, it's one for Kanu Pillars. What drama here in the city of Aba. Kanu Pillars pulling one back. Kanu Pillars back in it. Kanu Pillars are not lying down to be defeated by Enyimba. Kanu Pillars are back in it. And a yellow card has popped out of the pocket of the referee. We'll confirm who for. But Gambo Mohammed has pulled one back for Kanu Pillars.
Well, it is often said that you are most vulnerable when you've just scored. This is what Kanu Pillars have exposed. You saw Pele there, Rabiu, placing the ball for Gambo, who used his body to shield and set it to the opposite side of where goalkeeper Femi Thomas was to reduce the score line to 2-1. The very experience.
The first half is still a Kanu Pillars still. Al Hilal of Sudan won in this encounter. Chance for Kanu Pillars and what a goal! A goal for Kanu Pillars. Kanu Pillars has scored a goal, and that comes from number 9, and his name is Gambo Mohammed. Gambo Mohammed has scored, has equalized. Kanu Pillars, but still a solid play for them. They will have to score a goal match. That's Coach Ivor Sage. He's got his whip there. It's a whip and a few more. So for the past 40 minutes, he's been a shock, pressure, and slumber. He's a whip now and then.
If I must remind you, it was the same Gambo Mohamed was denied by the first bar in the early minutes of this game.
And then you see that goal again from Gambo Mohamed. The goalkeeper there, beating on the ball. That he rolls into the net. The two defenders there of Angola. And that chance for stopping again.
That's a great intervention. Opaku comes in. Solomon Opaku collecting that one. A good pass there. Good movement. Skills and movement. Gambo Mohamed was not able to get that one very well. Look at that miss. And that must be goal number one. Of course, it is goal number one. That is Ahmed Musa. He's back to doing what he knows best. The young man is simply unstoppable. Goal number 17 for him. An absolute joy to watch is that young number 16 for Canopilas, Ahmed Musa. When he killed that ball, he could have taken his shot first time. Decided instead, watch this one on a replay. He could have shot from that point. He decided instead to take it around the last defender. Nicked it into the bottom left corner of the net. Absolute harsh made of it there by Israel Waziri, who we were surprised to see his name in the starting lineup. And on the strength of that easy takeout from Ahmed Musa, it is...
Odinga with a header there, but it's Joseph Thompson and Pillars, and that one is queued forward. But Gambo Mohamed with an opportunity, that should be the equalizer, certainly. And it was not, and it's cleared away. The upright coming to the rescue of Sharks there. Gambo Mohamed did everything right, and oh, what an unfortunate one it is for Kano Pillars. So close and yet so far away, Kelechi.
Well, out goes Ahmed Musa and in steps Gambo Mohamed. That's the man of four goals, showing exactly what he can do there. He turned the keeper.
It wasn't quite so good, but somehow Shehu Shagari got his foot to it. But in the end, Gambo Mohamed was, of course, always going to be the target.
Well, just watch this one for composure from the striker. He turned inside his marker, flashed his shot. He beat the Okemutoda hands down, but he couldn't beat the far post. But very good industry from this man, Gambo Mohamed. Four goals on.
He's at this end, now it is at the other end. And Gambo Mohamed running in for that corner kick that's just accrued to Sharks. They've had so many corner kicks. A gently lifted one, and the header gets into it, but defensive all over. And that one is headed off the top right again. What have the Pillars players got to do to get the ball into the net? They've done everything here. And then luck, perhaps, and some good goalkeeping from Okemutoda have stood between them.
That time again is that man. That's the second time he'll be hitting the post in this game. Just watch the ball settled nicely for Gambo Mohamed. He got his head onto it, and just like in the first half, he slammed against the...
Work from Pillars that time, and that was very solidly done by Abubakar Baleria. But it is at the other end that it is happening now. Gambo Mohamed, an opportunity, and how did that one miss completely? And the referee said Ruben protesting, Victor Namo also not feeling too happy about that, but the referee is standing his ground.
Well, just watch when this ball came across. Well, I don't think it did take a touch off the hand of any player. When the ball was played here, the shot actually hit Okemute Oda. It hit it. Well, they are not giving up the fight.
Gambo Mohamed. Last chance, perhaps. Gambo Mohamed off target, finally. Golden opportunity there for Gambo Mohamed. And you can see what coach Babagunaru thinks of that. You can see what the spectators think. And this man is smiling beautifully. I'm sure it's not a real smile, Kelechi.
Well, I was wondering what the Sharks defenders were doing. They practically went to sleep, falling all over themselves, as if they wanted Gambo Mohamed to make sure he scored. Instead, maybe he also got surprised by the switching off of the defense line and practically smashed that one. One to Wiki Torres, another promoted side last week, and today they are down, same margin.
Poor defending that time, and that's a good shot. Good goalkeeping too. The referee noticed an infringement. They've been saved.
That's Hatsim Imout time for fans of Rising Stars. I didn't see what referee Benjamin Ode had blood for there. In any case, Morufo Lasupo, who's been outstanding for his team in the previous two games, pulled off another.
For the game, it's on Gambo Mohamed. He has a chance to shoot, and he shoots. A chance for Caterpillars to equalize. That was a very interesting timeout. A good shot, still the chance comes in. A left-footed one, skies it over the back.
No end product after some good link-up play by Pillars. That was another good save by Morufo Lasupo. When the ball was played back inside, this man, he took two exquisite touches but lashed the final effort over the crossbar. But I think the flag was more right a little bit that time. Though it looked suspiciously tight once again.
And that is the second goal, equalizer for Caterpillars. They've been looking around, trying to get it right. And finally, it has come for Caterpillars. It was a good move that went all the way. And this time, goalkeeper Lasupo has been beaten.
Beaten for the first time after nearly 250 minutes of football. But watch this one for a defensive breakdown. Absolutely nowhere Rabih Ali should have been free at that point. I did say the offside flag was going to fail at some point. It did fail. At this occasion, Rabih Ali, simply had to keep his composure, drag the ball forward just to set himself up and finish that one with aplomb. Wonderful equalizer. Nothing Morufo Lasupo could have done about that.
At the Teslim Balogun Stadium in Sulu, Lagos, deathless final of the Nigeria Federation's Cup. And Caterpillars have been pressing a lot. And it's a chance there by Caterpillars. Gambo Mohamed! That's the goal!
Gambo Mohamed, prolific scorer in the Nigeria Premier League. 15 goals in the league, has opened the scoring here. Take a look at that. Good run, left-footed shot, no chance for the goalkeeper. Had a hand to it, but it could not stop that. A powerful effort, left-footed shot, and just assisting the ball into the net. Great goal for Gambo Mohamed and for Caterpillars. Take a look at that again from another angle. The goalkeeper had his right hand to it, but could not stop it.